There's no fear. Everywhere is calm. Everybody coming to vote in a very calm atmosphere. And if it continues like this, I hope they have done well.
The sun actually came out quite early. It's still just about past 10 o'clock, before 11, and the sun is shining bright. A lot of people are seeing them. Older people are on the queue. What is giving the people of Rivers State, Gokana people, that strength of energy to come out today?
Yes. The Gokana people are very civilized people. They want to install a government of their choice. And that's why they are coming all out to vote in a government of their choice.
There are fears of rigging. Do you see that happening today?
Well, fears of rigging is not linked by the people voting. But we believe this time around, nobody will rig it. Because we can see the crowd coming out.
There are fears of security too.
Well, as it is now, the fear of insecurity is not there. You can see the number, you can see the turnout. If you are afraid of their life or one thing or the other, they wouldn't have been coming out in mass.
Yes. Thank you so much for talking to us on China's television. It's one of the elderly voters that we have seen today right here. There are all other younger voters. We have people who have strapped their children on their backs, and they do not care what the weather looks like. And are here today to exercise their franchise. Of course, we'll give you updates on what is happening. We've seen several incidents happen today. Arrest of a voter with double permanent voter cards. We've seen party agents agitated. But all of that, we're covering for you right here. Rivers Rerun, I will bring it to you on Channel Television. So you stick around for us. It's back to you on Sunrise this morning.
Thank you, Seung. We will keep you updated on what's going on in Rivers State. Seung is there with our team of correspondents around the areas that the rerun is taking place. We're talking about the right here. Now, Nora, before you carry on with your comments, I just opened a page here and I have my rights to life. Let me just read out some rights. Okay. My rights to life, my rights to the dignity of human person, my right to personal liberty, right to fair hearing, right to privacy, right to freedom of thought, conscience and religion, freedom of expression and the press, a right to assemble peacefully and associate, a right to freedom of movement, a right to freedom from discrimination, my right to property, as in to own property and all of that. So how you were talking about rights.
Let's talk about, right to, I think there's one about freedom, yes. You know, choice and all that. And that's why I said, in some parts, we're probably doing 0/10. I mean, we're all aware of the 14-year-old who has become a wife against the wish of her parents in Nigeria. You must have seen the fellow who was said to be an armed robber with a tire around his neck. That's Nigeria. And we can go on and on. Those are examples of, you know, rights. I mean, the number of cases of wife battering, whereby we still think that when a man marries a woman, he's bought her over. You know, she's become a possession, like his chair or table or whatever it is. And those are the things that are real to us in Nigeria. So I think that we must first have an agreement as a people that this entity called Nigeria should take its pride of place ahead of my tribe, my religion, my culture, etc., etc. And that's why I said we're still haggling. All right? Yeah. There's a haggling going on as to, you know, this human rights that we're talking about, how much of it would I accept? How much of it would my culture, my religion, whatever it is, allow me to accept? Until we agree that this is the minimum. So whether you are Igbo, Hausa, Edo, you know, you worship God, whatever it is you do, as a Nigerian, this is our minimum. Until we get to that point where there is a minimum that is applicable from Lagos to Sokoto, from, you know, from Benue, from Borno to Port Harcourt, we will still have this discrimination. That because today in Nigeria, human rights is colored by your position, your influence, your level of education, you know, the amount of money you have at your disposal. So until a Nigerian gets his rights, because he is a Nigerian at a very base level, mm-hmm. until we get to that point, this conversation about human rights is going to be an ongoing one. You know, it's going to be an ongoing one. Yes.
What would you say is a minimally acceptable standard? What should
be? The standard all over the world is what we call Universal Declaration of Human Rights. That is, even if the rights in of Nigerians will be different from people in Kenya, there should be a minimum standard. That is what we call fundamental human rights, civil and political rights. Maybe on socio-economic rights, where states have always been telling us that the resources are not there to make those rights enforceable. To some reasonable degree, is quite understood. But the minimum standard are already set on the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. That's why the argument of whether Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the argument of what they call cosmopolitan versus relativism, the way we should do it. But let me just say one thing. The state has been mentioned as to be blamed for... it's true, we're having human rights issues in Nigeria, and the report all over the world show that. But what we're also doing to one another as well, because we are all stakeholders. A young boy is alleged to have committed a crime, a suspect. And the next thing we do is to do arraign that boy,
and that is,
try him immediately,
and that is,
put tire on his neck, and set him ablaze without fear hearing. So the concept of
we really have to go. I'm so sorry, but we all right. have to go right now. I want to thank you so much, Ajola Oyinlade, UN Peace Ambassador. Thank you. Nora Edokpolo, Development Consultant, and Comrade Lale Olasukomi, ex Vice President, National Youth Council. Thank you all for sharing your thoughts.
Thank you.
We have to let go of this segment right now. Somebody's back in a moment. Please don't go away.